Making a Viking axe, tools required. I used a grinder, a cutting disc, a sanding disc, a knife, and a saw to make it. I used a square bit of wood to make the handle, and I used an old axe blade to make the axe and shape it up. Also, as well, I'll be using a Dremel at the end to put some Viking runes into the handle. So, here we go. Hope you enjoy. Dremel to Dremel out some Viking runes on both sides of the axe. They all mean different things, from strength through to many other things, and taken offline. I've also done a miniature Thor's hammer on the head of the axe. I've used a tiny little bit of wife's nail varnish in the runes, just to bring them out a bit, just to soak into the wood. I'm just gonna give it a light rub down with sandpaper after that, just to take some of the top layer off again. And as well as after I've done that, I'm going to get some old engine oil and give this another coating to allow it to soak in. that then is my finished product. I have put this over the top of the axe because I have children in the house, so you know, it eliminates fingers from messing. But yeah, all I have used, like I say, is my Dremel, some Silverline multiple bits in there as well. They've been fantastic. The main one I've used is, I don't know if my camera's gonna focus, no, the little ballpoint end, and then this tiny little cone shape one, just to take the edge off, you know, just the bits that are sticking up, and then run it on both sides like that afterwards. That's worked very well. I sound very pleased so far. So that is my Viking axe, created from a square piece of wood, an old axe head. Whatever that come off, I don't know. I got given it, but there we go. And I've made a Viking axe for reenactment purposes, or just to keep in your garage as a little novelty thing that I like and that I've made. My next project's probably going to be a Viking shield, but there we go. I'll show you again the finishing product soon.
Day in fear, day a friend, day in shalver it sama, and old steer day raldrey.
Well, I have finished the Viking axe, all done and dusted now. I'm quite pleased with the result myself. I'm definitely not a woodworker at all, so this is my first ever attempt, so yeah, I'm quite pleased with it. But here we go, I'll show you the finishing product. There we go. I don't know whether you can see that properly. Come in a bit there. But yeah, you can see the Thor's hammer at the top, engraved, lightly engraved. Not too bad, really. Then we've got the Viking ruins on both sides of the axe. The handle has actually been stained with a old motor oil. Now, I know you're not meant to use that, but I'm a great believer in recycling. And it seals the wood and protects it from water, so should extend the life of it, really. Not that this is going to be subject to weather or anything, because it'll just live in the garage now as a little thing I've made, and stay with me throughout. I might go ahead and blunt the blade, only because I've got children about. I do actually have a axe or a hand axe that I use, but that's safely kept in a high place in the garage where I'm stood. But yeah, there we go, everybody. Viking axe from the beginning till the end. So, if you want to have a go with it, and give it a go, and make one yourself, but you're no good at DIY and you're definitely not a woodworker, well, guess what? Neither am I. So, skill level needed to build this, I would say, I don't know, 3 out of 10. So, yeah, anybody can do it. Give it a go. You know, just take your time, don't rush. And that is it. Finishing product. Right, everybody. Goodbye.